I blink when I think of it. It seems that it should have been cold because I could see so many stars. Not that I ever paid attention to stars, my dear. Everything I see with my eyes, is at the same time overwhelming and boring as hell. Explaining that after proper hallucinogenic experiences, which includes excessive television viewing as well as illegal substances, extravagant visual images become less potent because you realize that in all actuality, you are presented with one at every moment of your life. So either you walk around in a constant dazed amazement, or you regrow that sort of numbness that pervaded unknowingly on the pre-drugged mind. Except now you're just a little bit less forgetful about numbness. That numbness that has its roots in all of our learned behavior and emotional chaos. So I blink to think of the snakes and scorpions which weren't there. It was in sand on a desert, on sand in a desert. We walked and I sung the Yamshka marching on because I had absolutely nothing to say and I was alone with this girl. Why was I writing this? In my memory, there are only two colors other than black or white. There is the brand new blue jeans, navy blue of the sky, and the scorpion shit brown of the desert sands. We were supposed to find each other at crack. Her eyes were on someone else. Maybe I was saying hello to the goodbye to the adolescent drive to fuck. Maybe I was just lonely, so I didn't want to be around anyone. It served to just remind me of it. We had climbed the windy and precarious top of one of those large, strange rocks, which gives so many boring towns and streets for a park. This rock was 50 feet high with a big hole in the center. It had some gay, happy gay, not homosexual gay, like keyhole or eagle's eye rock. We talked about something, I did this, you did that. I remember looking at picnic tables under the stone shelter down in the Springford Park area. It had those lovely bronze incandescents, and whatever color the table originally was, it had been transformed into a fairy tale version. How can I be so bored and nervous at the same time? God, is that what is the condition of my life? Bored and nervous! She was 18, and she was in love with a 40-year-old man who lived in a trailer park and went door-to-door on rollerblades selling homemade water filters. That sort of lifestyle was a bit hard for me to compete with. This is a true story, by the way. That's why we ended this friendship. I remained very insecure with myself until my middle 20s. Her ass was a little big, but she drove a Carmen Ghia, which we know for that. She had a pretty face, and she always seemed very happy. If not exactly interested in what I had to say, I was breaking a beautiful 16-year-old girl's heart into two. Meanwhile, the stupid bitch had the audacity to bore me with unquestioning love. That stupid bitch made me feel very guilty and bad. So neither of us were in the mood, and so nothing happened. This happens to be more often than romance. Nothing.